The health conversation continues here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show. We've reached that time of the year where we have out-of-town visitors. Money worries, Christmas shopping pressures, overeating problems, and a whole list of things that you never got around to doing. But along with the joy of holidays, so too does it bring along a host of stress and anxiety. We know all about it. And in fact, in 2016, a Bloomberg study declared South Africa the second most stressed out nation in the world. Wow! Can you cope with that?
No.
A lot. Looking super relaxed though this morning is Megan Pence-Kreitzer, who is here with some holiday stress advice. Megan, perfect timing. So good to see you. Good morning.
Why are you so relaxed?
Yeah,
like
why?
On a scale of 1 to 10, how stressful is being on Espresso Show?
No, it's not stressful.
No?
But I will say that what often happens with stress is it's usually long-term stress or extremely high levels of stress. And that's some of the be well, you know, health hacks that I have for you today is a few tips about, you know, stress management.
Yeah. I've spent quite a bit of time with you, Megan, and I almost feel like I know what you're about to say to me and Jamie Lee. I feel like you're going to say, guys, take it easy, pump the brakes, relax. Is that what you're about to say?
I am. And you know how important that really is?
Yeah.
Because if you look at relaxation, that's the one thing when you're very stressed that you actually don't do.
Mm.
So my advice would be 15 to 20 minutes a day, and you can choose. So look at firstly looking at something like meditation. Meditation is great because what it does is it focuses our attention. So all those thoughts that are all jumbled or whatever, it like just streamlines them a little bit. And then we, of course, have deep breathing. Now, did you know when you actually practice deep breathing, you actually then set off your parasympathetic response in your nervous system?
What's a parasympathetic response?
Okay, so that's our relaxation response. So it's a very important thing to actually look at deep breathing, and most of us don't breathe well. And then, of course, the other one is to look at, if you prefer, something like yoga. And yoga's great because what it does is it brings in deep breathing, it brings in you focusing a little bit, and then also at the same time, it also brings in that you are going to look at exercise. So we know that exercise actually does help, and also with posture. So these are, if you can
immediately going into perfect posture.
So try, you know, at least commit to one of those a day, and you're doing a great job at helping to reduce your stress.
I think the first thing people think when they think of exercise, it can be quite daunting, is that you've got to get out there and make an effort to do it. But something as easy as breathing, which is so interesting to hear you say, I can't believe that people have to be told to breathe.
How to breathe.
Insane. So, okay, so we're always seeing that a healthy breakfast, or saying it, we're seeing it, we're saying that a healthy breakfast and nutrition, good nutrition, can be great for you and great for a productive day. But where does nutrition fit into stress management? How does that play with each other?
So it is very important because what it does help to do, it helps to repair the body, which is very important. The other thing that really is something to look at is a healthy, balanced regular meal plan. And when we're looking at that, is it is very important to look at regular intake of our seasonal fruit and vegetables, have loads of those, and then incorporate protein, you know, moderate amounts, and obviously lean, and then go for your healthy fats. Now, the healthy fats are particularly our fats like our nuts, and we start looking at something like our oily fish, so our sardines and your salmon, and then, of course, let's not forget our canola oil, because they contain omega-3.
Yes.
And omega-3 has been shown with scientific studies, in actual fact, to help with healthy brain function.
Yes.
So that, of course, if you're very stressed and you've got a lot of anxiety, that's going to assist you.
Wow.
And what's nice about the Be Well canola oil, it actually has an ideal ratio of 2-to-1 from omega-3 to omega-6. So those are really good fats, and particularly omega-3. So you want to ensure that you actually take that in and keep it in the cupboard and use it as part of your stress management plan from a nutritional perspective.
Now, I love this. I love that you're telling us to have a good balanced diet, get some rest. Not actually, you said like relax.
Relax.
But then there's also this cliche where people constantly remind you, get some rest. Like all you need is a good night rest. As easy as it sounds, how important is it? But like with everyone's busy lifestyles, how do you just incorporate that into a balanced lifestyle?
Absolutely. So when it comes to sleep, you know, when we're stressed, what happens is, of course, we stress, and then we can't sleep, and we can't sleep, so we become irritable, we become irritable, and we can't sleep. So it's like a bit of a vicious cycle.
So cool.
Yeah. And when we actually do sleep, we help to reduce inflammation in the body, we help reduce, you know, oxidation, and it actually helps to repair the body as well. So one of the things that you can attempt to do firstly is, you know, regular sleep is obviously ideal, but to get into that habit, take technology out of the bedroom. Okay, don't look at your phone before you go to bed, because that can impact on your sleep. And so make it a haven, a place where you relax, because sleep, very importantly, assists us in reducing our stress.
Wow, Megan.
Megan,
notes
like,
on notes.
You're making me more stressed now because I'm like, I need to breathe properly, I need to have my posture and all of that. But thank you so much. I do actually feel a bit more relaxed. Like, I'm not even going to lie. Mm. But for all of you at home, you heard the lady. All you have to do is breathe, stay active, get some sleep, and eat healthy. Now, these are all the things that can help you have your best festive season yet and make that moment and make it a season to be jolly.
Yep.
But of course, while we still catch up a bit more with Meg,
with Meg.
We'll see you again after this.
Relax.